Today, we have come to the Windy City, Chicago to meet with James Oliver, who has 30 years of experience in the Chicago Police Department.
James has used that 30 years of experience to develop a highly complicated piece of embedded technology with virtualemployee.com, which is going to help save lives in emergency situations like gun crimes and fire emergencies. So please watch this very interesting and important case study to learn more.
To begin with, James, can you please just introduce yourself and tell us a little bit more about your background?
Yes. My name is James Oliver. I am a Chicago policeman for over 30 years in the organized crime division. So I am, pretty much familiar with crime and especially violent type crime.
James, how did you come up with this idea?
Oh yeah, well actually, let me back up a little bit. This system really started, I think it was 2013. We had a shooting here at a school, elementary school, where there was almost 20 kids, 4 or 5 years old in the classroom and got killed. Someone came in with a gun and started shooting and killed them. So I think that we're a better country than to have 4, 5, 6 year olds getting killed. I think that we should do something about that. With the way that technology is and the way this system is set up, we can do something about it. So that's what prompted me to come up, with the system. Actually, this system does a lot. It's actually a gun detection rapid response system.
Okay, so for those, for our viewers who don't know much about embedded hardware, can you just walk us through how this hardware will operate in, let's say, for instance, a school or a university?
Okay, well, this system actually worked this way. And what it will do is, let's say someone walk into a classroom and fire a gun. In a tenth of a second, the 911 operator can see and hear in that classroom. So it's a big thing for crime. And in my experience and my work is that a lot of time that we have responded to bank robbery, on our way to the bank, we pass by the offender because we don't know exactly how he looked, or the time frame or nothing. But with this system, you can see, they can see, hey, he's got on, he's got on a blue suit, he's got on a blue tie, Now you can see this person, that's the big thing with this system.
Why is this hardware important? Can't humans do what this system can do as a phone?
Human can make a call, but when there are shots fired, you are not making a call, even though you have your cell phone in your hand. When them shots is fired, you are not thinking about making a call. You thinking about survival. Once that shot is fired, the system take over. It's not gonna run, it's gonna take over. So that's what you want.
Could you please expand a bit more on that? How does it replace maybe a bank manager?
What it will do is replace a security guard standing there 24/7. Actually, having a security guard there at a location, most of the time, 99 9/10 of the time, that a perpetrator is gonna figure out a way to neutralize a regular security guy.
So James, what services have you taken from virtual employee and for how long?
Actually, it's been almost 2 years, I believe. And actually it's been engineers. I've had the opportunity to work with about three or four engineers, different kinds of engineer, you know, from the electronic engineer to hardware engineer and to software engineer. So I've had that opportunity to work with them, and it's been a blast.
And James, sometimes outsourcing or offshoring is criticized. Sometimes people say that it causes jobs here locally to be lost. What would your response be to those who criticize offshoring?
There's no way that a person, a middle class person like me, who's got a great idea, could take it to the next level. I couldn't have never done that unless I did that research and came up with virtual employee. I couldn't have never got it to the next step. It'd have been virtually impossible to hire someone locally. They'll talk to a company, but they're not gonna talk to an individual. Only way I could have gotten to this point was hire engineer from India. Otherwise, I couldn't have got here.
James, what were the greatest advantages of using virtualemployee.com services?
Actually, the biggest advantage that's working working with virtual employees was that you first have to have someone something that you trust and you feel comfortable with.
James, how much cost saving would you approximate you realize with VE?
I'm probably saving close to $250,000. That's what I'm saving. If the end product comes in the next couple of weeks, in which we are on target to meet, I'll be saving $250,000.
So James, your hardware and software engineers, did they meet your expectations?
Yes, they did. They met my expectation and far beyond. Some of the things that that they was able to do in the amount of time that they did is far reaching.
Okay, James, would you recommend virtualemployee.com service?
Yes, to anyone who want to save money, have a hands-on product, and yes, I would recommend it in a heartbeat.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Okay.